Sheena Wood. I'm married to Pastor Josh Wood, and we have been here for about 4 years, and we are so excited to be here. We love the church, and we love the people here. We feel like we are home. I had placed my faith in Christ at a young age, and then had decided when I was in high school that I needed to get baptized. And our church at that point in time had said that we had to complete a confirmation class of sorts. And after that confirmation class, I would be presented a contract and I would be asked to sign it or not sign it. And if I signed it, then I could get baptized. I didn't quite understand it, but I said, yes, let's do it. So I completed the baptism or the confirmation class and was super excited. And then came the contract that I had to read, and I didn't agree with all of the doctrinal things that they had asked for me to sign my name to. I did go to them and they actually said no, that I could not get baptized unless I signed that contract. And so I said, that's okay, I will not get baptized then. And so there I was. I met Josh when I was in freshman in college, and we had lots of conversations about our faith, and he asked me, when did you get baptized? And I kind of froze, because here I am talking to a soon-to-be pastor and I have not gotten baptized yet. So I felt so ashamed that I didn't really push for it. I should have just done it. And so I met with one of my sweet friends and asked her, hey, I know that you're the worship director at your church. Do you think that I could get baptized at your church? And she said, certainly. It's a Baptist church, which is what I had previously grown up into until we had switched churches when I was in high school. And she said that they would be honored to do a baptism for me. So I did it really quickly, and my parents weren't there. And I just did it in secrecy because I needed to do it real quick so that I could say, yes, I've been baptized, and then I can have a baptism story. I had a series of close family members and friends and family that started passing away, and I had found myself that thinking really hard about what Jesus did on that day that we celebrate Easter. And I was really convicted that here this God, human, came to earth and lived a sinless life and was ridiculed and mocked and tortured to death and walked himself into the grave on purpose for me. And here I couldn't even get baptized in front of my friends and my family. I had to do it in secrecy. And so I was convicted about my baptism. I didn't do it right. I did it in shame and in secrecy. I felt like I was burying myself too, that I had found myself in a grave with my family members that I wasn't called to be in. And so I got the buried in the likeness of Jesus' death. I got that part down really well, but I didn't get down the next part, raised in the likeness of his resurrection. And I was convicted of that, and the Holy Spirit moved me. And I asked Josh, I said, Josh, well, do you remember when I got baptized? And he said, yes, I do. He didn't even attend it. He wasn't even there. And I said, I didn't do it right. I did it out of shame and in secrecy. And in a world where we can stand for so much, here I am. I couldn't even stand in front of my friends and family displaying my faith and my relationship with this God who has saved me over and over and over again. I said, Josh, I think I need to get baptized again because I didn't do it the right way the first time. And I was expecting him to maybe have some reservations because here he is, a pastor on staff here in this church. This is only a couple years ago, and we had just gone through COVID. I had just buried my uncle and my grandma and my dad. And more than ever in that season did I realize that I was being called to stand up in front of my peers, in front of my church family, in front of everyone, and get baptized. And he was, and Josh was so excited. He said, absolutely, let me talk to Pastor Zach and figure out when we can do this. And we did it. And it was incredible. And Josh was the one who said,
buried in the likeness of his death, raised to walk in newness of life.
And I don't know about you, but I think that's a pretty beautiful thing. And I'm so glad that I could share that story with you, because that was only 2 years ago. And here I am, 36 years old, and I got baptized. Here I am, a pastor's wife, and I just got baptized, and I did it the right way, and it matters. So you might be wondering, okay, so I'm going to get baptized. Well, what happens after that? Is it just I get baptized and I go get dried off and then everything goes back to normal? No, when you get baptized, it is your public declaration of what life-changing experience Jesus did in your heart. And that changes you. So after your baptism, you got to express what is going on in the inside of your heart. And now, moving forward, your actions will express what God did in your heart. And so that will display itself in different ways for all of us. And I can't wait to hear about what it does for you. And for me, I was unashamed anymore. And I didn't know I was even living in shame about my faith. I was a pastor's wife. But here, I was so ashamed that I hadn't gotten baptized until I was in college. And so I hurried up and did it in the dark. No, God doesn't want us to be in the dark. He calls us to be in the light. He is the light. So for me, I get to stand up boldly in front of you guys, in front of the church, as a pastor's wife, boldly proclaiming my faith. And so can you. And I cannot wait to hear your story.